Thank you. Cancels it out. to know the truth. He wants to keep us in a place of, you know, what we see.
Mothers, you're right. We're from old school. I was young, but now I'm old. But I still get it together, don't you fool yourself. Young men, don't mess with me now. They got a man sitting over there, a real man. When time to get it together, Rubinstein, McClure can get it together. I thank God for Elder McClure. We're one. You see him, most of the time you'll see me. You see me, most of the time you'll see him. Why? Because even sit down, when God created us, He took Eve out of Adam.
Right.
Come on, somebody. That's why marriages have to be right. If they're not right, and they're not going to be equal, they're not going to be one. Even though God made him the head, I'm a part of him and his image. And during Adam's time, he brought all of that in. With us, we know that. So, women, it doesn't mean that the man is stronger than you. Come on. That means he have to treat you with no respect. That's due. You owe respect to your wife. You owe respect. I said, I'm talking about marriage. You owe that respect. And she's not trying to run over you. You just need to be equally yoked. Once you're equally yoked, you become one twine. When I teach, he teaches. When I preach, he preaches. Vice versa. Do y'all hear that? You know what I'm trying to say. Because it's no more me. It's no more. I'm the boss. No.
Teach.
You're not the boss.
Teach, woman.
And I thank God for this Yuri neck lady because she knows her place. Many women don't know their place. And many men don't know their place.
That's right.
Because if you don't study the word of God, you cannot direct or lead.
That's right. Amen. Tell it.
I gotta get to the word. I didn't mean to say all that.
Yes, you are. Teach.
But listen, something happens when you come to King's Temple. A change is made.
Amen.
Here in King's Temple. And that will remain in this house. It's an oil.
Right.
That's in this house. It's a covering.
Well.
Y'all should be shouting about all that. Cause this ain't everywhere.
They don't know how to count.
I've been a lot of places. I've seen a lot of faces. I've dealt with a lot of people. It's not everywhere. Let's be real here.
Right.
Amen. So when you have the covering and the oar over your house, keep it there.
Come on.
Get beside yourself. Now don't think that I got this. I'm in charge. No. This is God's house. I love you, each of you. To our elders, to our deacons, to our brethren, to each of you, I love you with the love of Christ. And I feel very honored. Humbly, I submit myself to the body of Christ. I think I got to tell you this because she don't, Sister Rochford knows something about me. She don't know everything. Can I be real? I was going to let Overseer McClure read it, but I won't. I brought my biography. But see, that's not important. But let me just say this. And maybe this will make you think. 2017, President Barack Obama, the president, our 44th president, gave gave yours truly the Legacy Lifetime of Legacy Award. Award. It's stamped by him. It's straight from the White House. Civil got his signature. Y'all don't hear that. And I don't know how many of you voted for him, but I'm gonna say he was the one. He was the first African American to stand up for you and I. So I count it a great honor. I hate to y'all. So, God is good. Now, I've received a lot of awards over the years. Citations, proclamations, all that stuff. If you need that to make me feel that I am somebody, which I already know who I am.
Yes, come on.
A lot of y'all worry because you don't know who you are.
There you go. Come on.
You are in the righteousness of God. You got power.
Teach.
If you have the righteousness of God, as the apostle said, you can move mountains.
Right.
If you have the righteousness of God, you can speak things into existence.
Right.
And they will come true.
Amen.
They will occur. You got to be holy and righteous.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. You can't go around working little roots and voodoo. Warlocks. Oh, let me get out of here. See, now that's not what I'm going to talk to you about. And I'm not going to be alone. But I got to give you what the Holy Spirit said. You can't go around hooking up with everybody. You better be very careful who you connect with.
There you go. That's right.
Why? Because Satan is on the rampage. And his main objective is to rob, to kill, and to destroy.
Right.
But I served notice on him today. Everything that he set up is already canceled.
Amen.
Everything you tried to set up, Elder Davis, is already canceled. Come on, somebody, and say cancel.
Cancel.
Get out of here. Greater is he that was in me. That's in the world. Now, I gotta stop because I know y'all ain't used to this kind of thing. Acts, the 12th chapter, at verse 5. Thank you, Jesus. Do you love the Lord?
Yes.
Do you love Sister Rubinstein?
Yes.
Don't need no title. Don't need no off. Don't need no big title. Don't need to try out outright. Hallelujah. Just live holy. And in this day that we live, you're going to have your ups and downs.
Yes.
You're going to have to walk by something or leave it alone.
Yep.
Oh, y'all don't be coming. Somebody start reading Acts 12, the 5th chapter, starting at the 5th verse.
He therefore was kept in prison.
Mm-hmm. Peter was where? This is Women's Day, but we got to go here because this is what Holy Spirit said. Peter was kept where? Read.
But prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him.
But notice, through prayer amongst the saints, it was made each day. The prayer is so important. If you don't have a prayer life, you cannot overcome the obstacles and the things that come in your way to stop your progress. See, life is a journey, as I said, but it's a process that we have to go through. And your prayer life is very important.
control somebody. That devil is a liar. Read.
And when Herod would have brought Peter forth,
read.
The same night Peter was sleeping between two soldiers.
Read.
Bound with two chains.
Read.
And the keepers before the door kept the prison.
Mm-hmm.
And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him.
Mm-hmm. The angel of the Lord came upon Peter while he was in prison, while the guards were standing at the door, while Bishop Rochford, they were trying to kill him. Come somebody. The Bible said that an angel of the Lord came upon him. Read, Mother Rochford.
And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, mm-hmm. and a light shined in the prison.
Read.
And he smote Peter on the side,
uh-huh.
and raised him up, saying,
uh-huh.
arise up quickly.
Now the Lord will speak to you sometimes. Yes. Not sometimes. He'll speak to you all the time if you remain in his presence.
Yes.
See, our thing is many people have gotten out of his presence. They think because of the way things are going in this world, the economy and what the president's doing and all the lies and all of that, that is, you know, showing them what to do. But when we remain in God's presence, there's nothing that will come on you unexpected. I want you to read to the 16th verse. All right. Then stop. Read.
He said, arise up quickly to Peter. And his chains fell off from his
head. Notice when the angel spoke, you got to hear somebody. You can't always think that it's about you. You got to listen to somebody. You need the chains to be broken. Amen? Didn't the girl sing the song about break every feather, every chains are broken? And when the chains, read,
and his chains fell off from his hand,
mm-hmm.
and the angel said unto him, gird up thyself,
mm-hmm.
and bind on thy sandal.
Mm-hmm.
And so he did.
Mm-hmm.
And he said unto him, cast thy garment about thee and follow me.
That was it. Is that verse 16?
That's 8.
That's 8? Okay, see, I'm getting out a little fast myself. All right. The angel spoke to Peter. You're following as she reads, right?
Yes.
The angel told Peter what to do. Well, no need of him fighting back. If he wanted to come out of those bondages and out of prison, I'm just telling you the way the Holy Spirit gave it to me. He had to listen to what the Holy Spirit was saying. See, our problem is sometimes, I'm not saying it's just you right here, I'm just talking as a whole. Amen. Our problem sometimes, we don't want the truth. You want anything but the truth. Come on, somebody. And as the angel spoke to Peter and told him, he said, now get up from here. Satan done kept you down long enough. He done kept you from doing what I have designed and created you to do. He done kept you in sorrow. He kept you depressed and lonely. He's kept you feeling like you're not going to make it. He kept you feeling like nobody's going to help you. Yeah. Like, look at somebody and say, that devil is a liar. Yeah. Read.
And Peter went out and followed the angel,
mm-hmm.
and was not that it was true which was done by the angel,
uh-huh.
but thought he saw a vision.
Uh-huh.
When they were past the first and the second ward, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth unto the city.
They had that gate. They had that gate now.
Which open.
I didn't mean to go this long with this, but I enjoy hearing her read. They're at that gate now to where the angel has spoken to the apostle. He told him what to do. And you're still sitting down like, nothing gonna happen. Everything's gonna stay the way it is. It stayed the way it is because you will not arise. It stayed the way it is because you're in lonely bond. It stayed the way it is because you won't realize you need God's help. You don't need nobody else's help. I tell young people everywhere as I go that And as I travel, and I love the young people, and I'm going to try to stay as young as I can, as long as I can. But I just love them because they're so real. You know, they tell you, I'm going to tell you, this is the way it is, mother, this is the way. And I just love them, Bishop, because they say, this is the way it is now, Bishop. You know, we're getting older. Some of us are still trying to remain in our little traditions. You can't tell me that I've been here longer than you've been here. What are you talking about? Maybe you have been here longer than I've been here, but you ain't got no sense.
That's right.
You still acting the same way? No change. Nothing has changed. Traditional. So the young person today, Karen, what they say is that, explain it to me. I want to understand why you feel the way you feel, or why you act the way you act. They don't understand about the Holy Ghost. Some of them don't, if they've been in the church. They don't understand about the anointing. They don't understand about respect. Come on, somebody.
That's right.
Bishop, excuse me, walk back and forth. They don't understand all that. They want to know, but they don't understand it. And unless those of us that have been here can take time in love and explain to them and not try to get them on our side to just like us. Come on, somebody. You will never reach them. Because they're in a whole nother world. They're doing things differently. Computer-wise. Amen. They're doing things differently. You can get on
That's right. There you go.
Okay, finish up now. So here we are. Read.
And when they were past the first and the second ward, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth into the city, which opened to them of its own accord. And they went out and passed on through one street, and forthwith the angel departed from Peter. And when Peter was come to himself, he said, now I know of a surety.
You gotta wake up. Look at somebody and say, wake up.
Wake up.
I'm almost finished. Say, wake up.
Wake up.
We've been sleeping too long.
Right?
Read.
And when Peter was come to himself, mm-hmm. he said, now I know of a surety mm-hmm. that the Lord hath sent his angel and hath delivered me out of the hand of Herod mm-hmm. and from all the expectation of the people of the Jews.
All right, that's enough. Stop it. See, y'all, I'm sorry, but I had to let her just read all of it. Because the word is right.
Right.
You might not like it. But it's right. We got to hear the word. Look at somebody and say, who's knocking at your door?
Who's knocking at my door?
I want to know. Look at your neighbor and say, who's knocking at your door?
Who's knocking at your door?
Oh, come on, y'all. Listen, saints, God's word is so relevant and timeless. This narrative gives us an example which could very well be a descriptive amount of many saints today. They have a prayer life, sincere in serving God diligently in their ecclesiastic assignment, but still do not live, said live, in the fullness of God. Who's knocking at your door?
That was for us on the school.
They do not believe what they pray will happen. They lack faith. Say faith.
Faith.
But Hebrew 11 and 6 says, but without faith, it is impossible. To please God.
That's right.
For he that cometh to God
of them that diligently seek him.
Yes.
God is the rewarder.
Yes, yes. Amen.
Not the witch.
Amen.
Call somebody.
Amen.
Oh, you say, oh, when I see things happening, and oh boy, and it happened. I make myself laugh sometimes. Listen, say, faith is not crumbling. Faith is not stumbling. Faith is not walking blindly in the dark. Faith is a conviction within that God's word is true.
Yes, yes.
Say true.
True.
It's the title deed. I said it's the title deed. To his provision. When you believe God.
Yes.
The problem very often is that you focus on things going on around you.
Yep. Yep.
And not on God's word.
There you go.
You're walking by sight and not by faith.
Yep.
Like Peter, when he was walking on the water to go to Jesus, but when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid and began sinking in Matthew 14, 29. But Jesus, you know the story, stretched out forth his hand. Saints, I'm talking to the saints. Say, listen, I'm talking to the saints. But Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him and said to him, oh, thou of little faith. Faith, did you doubt me? Keep your eyes on Jesus. Look at somebody and say, keep your eyes on Jesus. Not on me.
Always.
Without faith, it is impossible to please God. But women of God, nothing. Men of God, nothing, say nothing,
nothing
is impossible,
impossible
for us if we trust him.
Yes.
I said trust him. I can get this deep. When I teach or when I do my little stuff, I went to school for a few years under this great leader of yours, Bishop Rochford, and I got my degree in, what, how do you say it, methodology? Methodology. I graduated. I went on to school a little bit further, and I got another degree. And I was so glad when he worked, because I know him and Sister Rachel work in the prisons, and they do such great work helping the prisoners there, and so forth. And that's work. Went to the prisons with him. Went to the prisons with Mother Washington. All of us would go together.
Yep.
Amen. God took me on from there, took me overseas for 8 years, went over there in Belize, did what I had to do over there for 8 years, didn't get a dime, and I told y'all that before, this church. But Elder McClure and I, over in Belize, serving over there, amen, taking people's stuff that they need, because they didn't have nothing to give you but bananas. Oh, I can tell y'all some stories. I guess that's what the president saw in us too, when we talked to him. Did so many things, amen, not pat myself on the back, but just let you know where we come from, what the Lord has done. So Bishop Rochford was such a help in, like, how can I say it? Like in monitoring us along the way, because the more I worked with him and the saints and various ones, the more I learned what real life is all about. And it's not about how many times people call your name or how much money you give. Come on, somebody. Or who face you always up in. Because see, you ain't gonna stop where God wants to take place. He's not going to stop what God wants to take place. So here we were, just doing what God said to do. And now God is taking me to a place to whereby I don't need your praise. I don't even need you to call my name.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus. Let me get back. I went to school. I got a degree in a little stuff. And thank God for that. Amen. But I can... I like Rubinstein. Do you like you?
Yeah.
When I like me, you can't hurt me.
Yeah.
You gotta
that kind of stuff. But can nobody hurt you if you know who you are? Don't be afraid. Your faith. The dominance of evil and perversion has infiltrated our society. We find ourselves in the midst of a battle that does not leave room for prisoners of war or wounded soldiers. Just had them in battle the other day. They had a special thing coming down on Sunrise Highway for the warriors, the wounded warriors. Yes, Mother. Those that have gone on, those that are wounded in not only in their minds, many people are wounded in their minds. They're not only legs and arms, but they're wounded. The whole church sometimes is wounded in their mind. For we have a formidable foe with an arsenal of weapons of mass destruction. Who shows no mercy. Says shows no mercy. Do you know where you are now? Satan is a prince of this world. He don't want to show any mercy on the saints. Because elder, he comes to rob from you. He comes to kill you. He comes to steal from you. Your family, your children. Look at our children that are dying. If anything, he's going to make it harder. Thank you, Jesus. He has only one thing in mind, and that is to steal, to kill, and to destroy the souls of men. But God has equipped the saints. Say, God. Come on, y'all. Now. I'm going to tune up after a while. Say, God has equipped the saints. He's equipped us with everything that is required to destroy the weapons of the enemy and to bring deliverance to those who are bound by sin. See, your whole purpose and my whole purpose for living and even existing up to now is to destroy the works of the enemy.
Right.
Those that are bound, that they can be released. I said that they can be released from bondage.
Yes.
Our equipment can be summed up in one thing, and that is the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I know this pastor, this bishop, has done that all his life, and he still does it.
Right.
It seems so simple that one would think that cannot be all that we need, but it is. His death, his burial, and resurrection cancels the sentences of death for man. Jesus Christ's only purpose for entering into this world was that man might have life.
And more abundantly.
And that more abundantly, Mom. That was his purpose.
Yes.
That we would have life. Do I have some others that agree with me?
Yes.
That we would have life. And that more abundantly.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Women, this story we must proclaim. This is over. We're giving out the war cry. It's an old story, but the focus does not change. We must, however, change the strategy by which we tell the story. What worked in the past sometimes will not work now. You see the praise dancers? Beautiful. Beautiful. Trying to bring it, but it's going to take more than just praise dancers.
Yes.
It's going to take the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
To bring in the presence of the Lord.
Right.
Amen. So the praise dancers, Proverbs 11 and 30 gives us to know that one that wins souls is wise. And how do we obtain the necessary wisdom if any man lacks wisdom? How do we obtain that wisdom, elders, if you're not asking God? Hush up now, don't go short. For wisdom. See, I'm happy right now. He that lacketh wisdom, ask wisdom of God. But now, if you're one that
on the way you're going. Thank you, Jesus. Through our prayer life and faith, I'm really dealing with faith and hope. Don't you give up. Through our prayer life and faith, God will teach us how to meet them on their terms and help us to present Christ in such a manner, that's why I keep on shouting, that even the most foolish of men will understand. The foolish of men will understand. And the wisest of men will be confounded by the gospel of Jesus Christ. So here we are, Elder Davis. We're in a time where the prince of this world is Satan. We're in a time, we know where we are. Know this, that faith and hope, said faith and hope, will give you courage. You got to have some faith in God. Keep your hope alive. Faith and hope working together is a powerful force. You don't give up because times are hard, or because you don't have money, or because you don't have what you want, or because they haven't given you the position that you think you should hold. That's what you're thinking. Hope arouses your mind to explore every possible angle. Hope and faith enables you to overcome all. I'm happy now, because I know where I am. Faith and hope will help us to overcome all. I didn't say some things. I said all. Thank you, Jesus. Will help us to overcome all obstacles. It's the fuel your heart runs on. You know how a car gotta have the gas in it, and the price is going up higher and higher, but you gotta have gas in it to keep it moving. Even sometimes when other parts on it ain't working right, you gotta put that $3, it's almost $4 in some places. You gotta put that gasoline in that car for it to keep running. You don't put any gasoline in it, you can't come to church and dance. If you don't put no gasoline in it, you can't come on somebody. If you don't pray, if you don't fast, you ain't gonna have no power. You gonna sit there and look pretty. Oh, I've seen so many people like that, Elder, in our church. Women of God, men of God, don't you ever give up. Now, if you give up, I don't mean in trying to force your way, because your way is not God's way. Our thoughts are not His thoughts. A day, come on, 1,000 years, come on somebody, the way you're thinking is out, it's not in order with kingdom work. Even act like you want me to act. But we want the will of God to take authority in the house. We want the Holy Ghost to reign in the house. We want God to move so those that are sick can be healed. Matter of fact, you're already healed if you just stay and believe it in your heart. Thank you, Jesus. Don't ever lose your hope. It's what made Abraham leave home without knowing where God was taking him. But don't lose your hope.
Right.
Don't lose your faith.
Right.
Don't give up on God. Faith always contradicts your circumstances.
That's right.
What faith is, faith will save you.
Amen.
Faith will sanctify you. Faith will Holy Ghost fill you.
Yes.
Faith will lead you and guide
Hallelujah.
You. Faith will secure you.
Yes, Lord.
Faith will help you to walk through the darkness.
Yes.
Faith will help you pray. Amen. Faith will help you to resist the devil. Thank you, Jesus. So I say to you, be strong in the Lord. As Paul said, and be mighty in his works. Not your works, his works.
Yes.
A group of praying saints, let me get right quick to this, and then y'all can go to the Then, here in our story, here we find Rhoda, a woman. Come on. They thought she was mad, Bishop. You done read all of it. They thought she was mad. She ain't had no sense. She shout all the time. She clap her hands all the time. She shouts all the time. We need some dignity in the house. The dignity is in the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Group of praying saints, they got together in their home of Mary, the mother of John Mark. And I'm sure they were sincere about their prayers. But let me point this to you. But it seems like to me they just really wasn't expecting God to show up. Maybe they thought the whole situation would just go away. Come on, somebody. But whatever their mindset was during that time of prayer, it's obvious, Bishop, that they were not praying in faith.
Yes.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. It's here in Acts we find King Herod relentless and his attack on the church. The attack of the enemy is on the church. The church is within you.
Right.
Not the building.
That's right.
Oh, I know I'm going on. It's not the building, although we gather together
in the
building.
Church.
We're glad to see one another. We're happy to see each other. But the church is within you and I.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Mom.
It's within us.
Yes.
Amen.
We are.
Here, they're gathering in prayer. But their faith wasn't strong enough.
Mm-hmm.
Their hope, they didn't believe what God's word was saying. So here come Peter. He done got out of jail. And you still trying to mess with Peter. When God brings you out.
Come on.
Come on, somebody. Shut down. Take the limits off of God.
Right, there is no limit.
Loose yourself.
You
keep your mind focused where it should be.
Yes, right.
When I choose to walk by faith, I open standards for God to be glorified.
Come on.
And that's in 2 Timothy. You open standards for God to be glorified and not man.
Hallelujah.
You open faith and hope for God to heal bodies and not people.
Amen.
Come on. We open faith for God to do a work that nobody can do but Him.
Right. Peace, woman of God.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Yes.
When you choose to live by faith, the kingdom, say kingdom, can be advanced.
Be advanced.
The kingdom. See, I do kingdom work.
Man.
I try. I'm not perfect, but I try to do kingdom work.
Yes.
I don't try to do everybody else's job. Rubinstein's taking care of what God has appointed me to do.
Amen.
And that's, baby, kingdom work. Yes. That's not to outdress you or outshine you, because see, if you know who you are, you ain't jealous no one.
That's right. Tell it. Teach. Talking truth. Amen.
The test that we go through is not just to reveal your faith, but to refine it. Say, refine it.
Refine.
Uh-huh. That kingdom has to come. God has to be glorified.
Yes.
That's what He's asking you and me to do if we're really born.
tell.
I felt something. I didn't understand it all then, but I felt something. And I knew it was going to be the Holy Ghost that's going to have to, you know, do away with some of the stuff that had me in bondage and had me tied up and had me think that everything was all right. I had to get out of myself, and I had to glorify God.
Yes.
That's what the church and a lot of people don't want to do. They want to remain in who they are. And as long as you let them remain in who they are, let them go. Hallelujah. But once you say yes to the Lord, and that's why I believe, I really believe that Dad Mason, that was one of the reasons when Mother Lyman and them came along and Mother Robinson and them, they would have the people say yes.
Afraid of those
that think they're in charge. Because I see you. That's why I keep on praising God, and
right.
We're going to do this thing together.
That's right.
If I speak to you,
you better know and you better believe that
right.
God said.
Right.
I'm not a waste of time. God said. God said. And he cannot lie.
Right.
Where his word has accomplished, everybody standing.
Amen.
It will not come back
void.
Who's knocking at your door? Who's telling you what to do? Who's giving you orders? And the only way, Mama, we find out those orders is through his word. Bishop, you can have it, because I'm so glad to be here with y'all. I love you so much. Who's telling you what to do? Yes, we respect leadership. We respect leadership.
Think for us.
This church is about that. But at the same time, I'd rather obey God than man.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much, baby. I forgot them shoes was in there. My feet feel so comfortable. Who's telling you what to do? Are you reading God's word? I know here in King's Temple, those of you that are members, you've had the best of leaders, and you have the best of leaders.
Yes, yes.
But here the Holy Spirit is there. Life will not change until we change.
Right.
Who's knocking at your door? Peter, Rhoda heard this, and she got so excited that she ran back to where the prayer meeting was and began telling other people. She didn't even open the door for Peter. And he had been in prison all the years.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
She didn't even open the door for Peter. So she ran back. She was excited. That's what she was.
Yes.
She was excited like some of us get. As women, you know we get excited.
Yes.
Men, we do get excited.
Yes.
But she didn't even open the door for Peter. And he was there to show them and to let them know, I'm released.
Yes.
And somebody said, I'm released.
Yes.
I'm released from sickness.
Yes.
I'm released from death.
Yes.
I'm released from everything that's not of God. Lift
yes.
your hands and say, I'm free.
I'm free. Yes.
Be free. No more weeping, no more crying. Because even though we have to endure some things, man, I'm not telling you it's going to be easy. Because I've been through it. And I still go through it. Hallelujah! But when I stay on my bended knees, when I say yes to the Lord, when I study his word, amen, no devil in hell, come on somebody,
come on.
Can stop what God has already preordained and preordered.
Amen, right. Hallelujah.
I love you. I love Bishop. And I want to especially thank those dancers for that beautiful dance. Because you know why? Because the flowers, as Donna Lawrence said, we are at the feet of Jesus. You are at the feet of Jesus. There's somebody this morning. And I see the bishop standing here, and I respect him. Man of God, no, go stand. I'm going to give it to him, because he's a born evangelist. Y'all know that. Y'all know that. He's
right.
A bishop. He's got another title now, but it all started with evangelism.
That's right. That's right.
I'm going to let him pray. Elder McClure, I love you, and I respect you. But I'm going to let Bishop pray.
Amen.
Amen. And let Bishop come forth. And we, missionaries and mothers, don't lose your power. Activate. You hear me, Karen? Sister Rochford? Activate your power. You got the Holy Ghost, you need to get it hot.
Powerful. Powerful word. Powerful message. Amen.
She chose the appropriate message. And some of you mothers are praying for your son to be released. John and Mark was the mother, Mary of Jerusalem was in charge of it. That was her house. Some of y'all are praying for your sons.
Yes.
Some of y'all are praying for your daughters. And that was an appropriate text. Yeah. Because she prayed. That wasn't his mother that answered the door. And he said it was Rhoda. You gotta have some believers praying with you.
Right, right.
She sure left him at the door. And it wasn't an indictment against her. It was just that she was so stubborn. Some of y'all gonna see the result of your prayer so quick. You're not gonna believe it. I've seen the result of prayer that happened so quick. You couldn't believe it. You see, so this is an appropriate text. Because I know a few of you are praying for some loved ones that are bound. Yeah, and he was on death row. But he was going to die the next day. And I love that text. Mothers need to hear that. You know, because God has spared a lot of your children. And since it's one woman's there, I have to say it that way. Because when my wife went up to see my son, Christopher, I couldn't believe he could come off of that. All those different respirators and everything. And get on the phone itself. And when I spoke to him, the tears came down my eyes to know that God does what he wants to do.
Hey, the healer. What a soul.
Sister, I have someone I want you to speak to. I said, she's at the hospital. She asked me to speak. It was Christopher. After going through all that traumatic experience, you got loved ones, but your prayer reaches further than you think it
does.
God raised him up, and he's back teaching in seminary. You don't know who your prayer's gonna reach. Yes, keep that praying Bible, man. But intensify it. Get some more people in there praying. Get some more miracles in this church.
Let us stand on our feet. I am so happy to see that the prayers of the righteous man availeth much. You know, this morning, we, Mother Leona, we probably, while you were on your way driving, we were praying for you. Sister Banks, they told us you was at the emergency room. But look at God. Amen. We prayed for you. In the name of Jesus. Is there anyone who have heard the gospel message of Jesus Christ today?
Jesus.
And as the word went forth, you just heard this knocking at your door. The preacher asked the question, who's knocking at your door? You cannot always believe that it's the Holy Spirit, because there are other spirits spirits that come.
Right.
Knocking at your door.
Yeah.
And you got to know whether to answer it or whether to do something like roll it in. Just kind of like run back and do some more praying. Yeah. Those of you that have felt the unction of the Holy Spirit knocking at your door, won't you come? Open up the door and let him in. Jesus is knocking. Won't you come? You have an opportunity. The songwriter said, don't let it be said too late. Don't let it be said too late. All right, those of you that have special prayers, Sister Faith, our preacher spoke about faith today. You're going to come up here and we're going to pray for your mother. The doctors, while I was there, said, asked me to call the family. He said, because her mother is very sick and I need to speak with the family. So we want to you to stand in the gap for your mother, because God still works miracles.
Yes.
I'm a witness. God still works miracles. Now her mother's on her respirator, and the doctors are almost saying there's nothing more they can do.
Jesus.
So we're gonna give it over to God.
Right.
Anybody else have a need and a concern? We need power. Power of the Holy Ghost to lay hands on the sick that they would recover.
Yes.
You can come.
Still believe.
Because prayer still works. Prayer still works. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus shall prevail.
Jesus reigns. Every fetter.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus
Thank you.
She belongs to God. shall be manifested.
Shall be manifested.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
I told you not to get in this circle if you didn't mean what you're saying. Hallelujah. Come on, clap those hands. Cheese. Say cheese. Say cheese. Say cheese. Cheese. The blood of Jesus.
Right.
And she touched on it about the witch.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all remember that?
Yeah.
This morning.
He spoke about this morning.
Bishop White.
Yep.
This was not a recording. This was actual happened this morning at Zion.
Yeah, I watched.
Said the Lord said somebody needs to get witches off of them.
Yeah, that's right.
And people came up to get delivered.
Yes, it is.
And then this woman of God comes here to let you know God is breaking the spirit of manipulation off of your life.
There you go. Hey. Confirmation.
The spirit of witchcraft no longer has control over you.
That's right.
Hey. Right up in here. The devil has left. I say the devil has left. The devil weapon born against you.
He has no joy. He has no joy.
When sister, my wife, and and some of the missionaries walk through here. Do you not know this area is being attacked demonically?
Yeah.
And some of the hindrance is because we won't get free. We're not getting free. And if the people inside the church don't get free, how do you expect the ones outside to get free?
Hey.
Some of our children are in trouble. They're caught up in drugs. Some are caught up in prostitution.
Yeah.
And listen, we got to really seriously pray. We got to go on a fast. And we got to ask God to send revival. Because ain't no use in dead people coming in when dead people are in here already.
Uh-oh. Oh, tell it.
God ain't going to send no dead folks outside that's in the Bloods and all these gangs. Yes, we have authority over the gang. Because the driver of John Gotti came here. And they sent him to me. Now he's on parole. And he asked for me to join this church.
All right.
Yeah. Now, I'm not talking.